Ork Boyz are known for attacking in huge numbers, using sheer ferocity and brute strength to overwhelm their enemies. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint one such Ork Boyz in the colours of the Goff clan. We're going to be painting it using the classic paint method, and we're going to paint the model up to battle ready. As with any Citadel miniature, the first thing you must do with your model is to make sure that you undercoat it, and we've chosen to spray ours using Mechanica Standard Grey Spray, which you can see is what I've got just here. This is because this colour is a really good starting point for not only the skin, but also all the leather and all the clothing as well. Now, the first colour that we need is Deathworld Forest, and this is for the Ork skin. And I'm going to be applying it using a medium base brush because this is quite a large area, so this brush is a really good size for this sort of detail. Now, throughout this video, you're going to see me using a palette, and I recommend you do the same. It's because it allows you to get the paint on there and to test it to see how thin it is. And if it's a bit too thick, like it is here, it allows you to add a touch of water to the mix to thin it down so it's nice and smooth. And doing this means the paint goes further, it dries smoother, and it gives you more control over it as well. So once you've got that mixed together, all you need to do is load up your brush, just twist it to make sure it's not overloaded with too much paint. So there we go. And once you've done so, you're then ready to start blocking in all the flesh on your orc. So what you need to do is just start painting it like this, making sure you work that colour into all the little nooks and crannies. Once you've finished base coating the skin, you're ready to move on to applying the remaining base colours onto the miniature using the same method. Now, first of all, we need a Baden black, and this is going to be for the black armour and other details, and then we'll move on to Rhinox hide to base coat in all the brown leather details. After that, we're ready for the metallic details, and for this, first we need lead belcher, and then we're going to use some Balthazar gold to break up the larger areas of silver. Finally, we need a bit of Xandri dust to paint in the bone details, the most obvious of which is the teeth. But first of all, we're going to be using a Baden black, and once again I'm going to be applying this using my medium base brush. So as before, let's get some of this paint onto your brush, then put it onto your palette like this so that you can add a touch of water to it to thin it down. So you don't need very much, just a little bit like that. Let's make it a bit smoother so it applies smoother. Now, when it comes to painting black, there's only really one area that you have to paint black, and that is the armour. So in the case of this boy over here, we're looking at this big shoulder plate around here. As for the clothing, you can paint as much or as little of it black as you like, and bits that you don't paint black, you can then later on paint brown. And if you mix this up across the unit and approach it in quite a random way, you'll get a real ramshackle appearance to your unit, which is perfect for Ork Boyz. I finished painting the Ork's armour with a Baden black, and you can see as well I also picked out some of the clothing and the boots as well. And with that done, we're now ready to move on to Rhinox hide. Now, this is for all the remaining leather straps and also the remaining clothing as well. Once you've finished painting in all the leather and the clothing, you're then ready to start painting the metallics. And first of all, for this, we need lead belcher to paint in all the metal details. Now, some of these are quite small. For example, there's a ring in the ear just here. And for those smaller details, just switch to a small layer brush for a little bit more control. Once you've finished applying the lead belcher, you might find there are some very large areas of silver, and you can break these up with some Balthazar gold by applying it on some of the panels. For example, on this one on the side of the shooter, and also a small area around the muzzle. And finally, using Xandri dust to base coat all the bone details. Now, the obvious example here is, of course, the teeth, but there are some smaller ones to keep an eye out for. On this particular orc, we've got a little tooth on his earring just here, so we need to get that. And also, keep an eye out on the fingers as well, because you need to pick out the claws on these fingertips. And there we are, we've now finished applying all our base colours, and we can move on to the next stage, which is to apply some shade paint onto the miniature to give it some depth and really bring out the detail. The only colour we need for this is Agrax Earth Shade, and we're going to be applying quite a lot of it, so I'm going to apply it using a medium shade brush. And what you want to do is just get a load of this paint on the brush, then put it onto your palette. This isn't to water it down, because it's best not to add any water to shade, but instead it's so that we can judge exactly how much we're applying at once. And to begin with, you want quite a lot, but as you get to the finer details, you want to be putting on less, so having the palette really helps in doing that. But to begin with, really load up lots on your brush and just start painting it all over the miniature, and you'll see it runs into the recessed detail and helps it stand out. Now you can see on the face, just like that. So all you need to do is paint this all over your miniature, and once you've done so, give it around about an hour to dry. As it's drying, keep an eye on the shade, and if you see it pooling in large areas, just move away the excess paint before it's dry. For example, if you see it really building up in large amounts like on there, that's what you want to be looking out for. So if that happens, just move it away like that. Once that shade is completely dry, you're then ready to add some textured paint to the base of the miniature. For this, we're going to use Agrellum Badland. Now, to apply this kind of paint, what you need is a texture tool, and with this sort of miniature, because it leans over so much over the base, I recommend you start with the narrow side of the tool to get a small amount of this paint, because it'll give you a little bit more control as you place it on the base. And you see, what you need to do is just go under there, put it onto an open spot on the base, and start moving it around, just taking it right up to the feet, like this. Now, once you cover the top of the base with this paint, give it about an hour to dry, and once it's dry, all you need to do is paint the rim of the base. And for this, I'm going to be using Steel Legion Drab. And with that textured paint completely dry and the rim of the base painted, this Goff Ork Boy is now battle ready. So when you're painting your Goff Ork Boys like this, there's a few key things to remember. The first is that you should always make sure you use an appropriately sized brush for the area of detail that you're covering, which in the case of this model is usually going to be a medium base brush, but it's a good idea to have a small airbrush on hand for the finer details. Also, always remember to take your time and be as neat as you can, because the neater you are, the better the final result is going to look. But really, that's all you need to know, and we really hope you have loads of fun painting your boys. We'll see you all again very soon.